Hello students, now we are going to discuss about the drainage arrangements for the high-rise buildings. The drainage arrangements are necessary for high-rise buildings in order to collect the wastewater generated from the different fixtures. The drainage arrangement is generally called sanitary plumbing. So the wastewater generated from bath and kitchen is called sullage. So the wastewater are of two types. The wastewater generated from the bath and kitchen is called sullage, and the waste from the toilet is called excreta. The sanitary plumbing shall be the pipes and fixtures or appliances installed in a building in order to collect the sullage and the excreta. So for collecting the sullage and excreta, so we need the sanitary appliances. The sanitary appliances are the fixtures installed in the residential building to receive the wastewater. So they shall be of two types, namely the soil appliances and the waste appliances. Soil appliances are the fixtures connected to a soil pipe. The soil pipe generally collects the waste from toilet fixtures, water closets. Okay. Soil appliances are the fixtures connected to a soil pipe which carries the toilet waste, the excreta, from the building. The examples of the soil appliances are the water closet, the bidet, urinals, and so on. So these are the European closets. Similarly, there are Indian closets, the urinals of different types, the gents urinal, ladies urinal, the street urinals, and all public urinals, in order to collect the urinals. And the waste appliance are the fixtures connected to the waste pipe which carries the sullage from the building. The examples of soil appliances are wash basin, bathtub, and kitchen sink. So it is necessary to collect the waste and soil separately, because this excreta has the pathogens, because the human waste contains the microorganism, particularly the disease causing pathogens, that should be properly collected. And the waste is also likely to degrade anaerobically, and the gas will be generated, so within the system. Therefore, it is preferable to collect the soil through a soil pipe and the waste through the waste pipes. So these are different types of wash basin to collect the wash water, the hand wash, and also the sinks, kitchen sinks, to wash the utensils, and so on. So this is a typical bathroom, consists of the bathtub, the water closet, wash basin arrangements. So all these arrangements are to collect the wastewater from the household. The important fixture for the sanitary appliance is the trap. So a trap consists of a U-tube which retains water, which acts as a water seal in order to prevent the foul gas entering into the building. Because as I told, the waste, the excreta, is likely to cause decomposition due to the presence of microorganism within it. And the absence of oxygen, anaerobic decomposition take place, which generate the foul gases like hydrogen sulfate, methane, etc. Particularly hydrogen sulfate is a very foul smelling gas, and the methane is inflammable gas. We have to prevent these gases entering into the household. So only the trap prevents these gases entering into the household with the water seal. So water seal is the water retained in the U-tube. Normally, the depth of water seal varies from 20 mm to 75 mm. If the depth is greater, then the seal is effective. That will prevent the gas effectively. But we need more water for flushing. When the water seal is greater, the water required for flushing is also will be greater. For a good trap, there are certain requirements. A good trap should be provided with a sufficient water seal. So without water seal, there is no purpose of the water trap. The inside of the water trap should be very smooth, because the waste should not stick on to the inner surface. It should flow freely without any stagnation or clogging. Therefore, inside of the trap should be very, very smooth, and it should be provided with an access door for facilitating the cleaning when it is required. And it should be made of non-absorbent material, because it has to retain the water seal. If the material in which the trap manufactured is of water absorbent, then the water seal will be lost. Therefore, normally it is manufactured with cast iron or porcelain, so that the water seal will be maintained without any loss. There are different types of traps. So, based on the shape, they are classified as P trap, Q trap, and S trap. Apart from this P trap, Q trap, and S trap, the traps are also classified as floor traps, gully traps, and intercepting traps, according to the location where these traps are provided. So, the figures show the different types of traps. The P traps, the traps looks like inverted P. So, this is the water seal maintained, and the depth of water seal is the difference between the weir and this bottom. So, this is the water seal. This water seal should be 20 mm to 100 mm. Okay. So, this is a P, inverted P, and this is a Q trap. This looks like Q, and this is called S trap because it looks like S. So, these water closets are provided with the traps here. So, this is the trap provided to this closet. Here you have the trap. These traps are inbuilt with European water closets. So, all the closets are manufactured with the trap. So, this is the P trap. Here you have the S trap. This is a Q trap arrangement. Here the trap is fixed to the water wash basin. Here this is the trap arrangement, fixed to the bottom of the wash basin. So, here is the floor trap. The purpose of floor trap, it to receive the wastewater from kitchen and bathroom. So, the sullage water is going through the trap from the top. In the trap, you have the water seal, which prevents the entry of gas from outside to inside. So, these are manufactured with cast iron or galvanized iron. So, mostly provided in the bathroom and kitchen at the floor level, embedded into the floor, so that the sullage flows to the trap through the holes provided in the top of the trap. We have the gratings, the galvanized grating or GI grating, through which the water enters. So, this is the gully trap. So, in the gully trap, you have another provision. So, apart from the sullage water entering from the top, here sullage water is coming from the side, whereas the rain water and other floor water is coming from the top. So, there are two entry to this trap. That is why it is a gully trap. You have a branch which allows the bathroom water, kitchen water to enter, and the floor water coming from the top. This also connected to the house drain. So, this is the intercepting trap. It is provided at the end of the house drainage connected to the street drainage. So, an intercepting trap is often provided at the junction of the house drainage and the street drain. So, in order to prevent the foul gas from the municipal sewer to enter into the household. So, it has a high water seal. So, other fixtures has a smaller water seal, some 40 mm, 50 mm. Here you have to provide a greater water seal of 100 mm, because this is connected to street sewer, where the gas generation will be greater. So, we have to prevent the entry of gas from the sewer into the house. And here you have a deep water seal. In this intercepting trap, there is a provision for cleaning arrangement. A plug is provided. In case of any blockage, we can remove this plug, and then we can put a rod a flexible rod and clean the drain system. Because it is a solid waste and when the velocity is less, the solids are likely to settle and the clogging in these drains is a common problem in the house drainage system. Therefore, in all the trap, we must have the provision for cleaning arrangement. So, this is a sanitary plumbing in a bathroom. You have the water closet, wash basin, all are connected below the floor level through the pipes and T connections, etc. So, in any sanitary plumbing design, say you have to consider certain important points. So, all the pipes should be laid in the ground by the side of the building, not in the wall, because here leakage is likely to come from the joints of the pipe that may damage the building. So, to avoid that, all the sanitary pipes are laid in the ground by side of the walls. So, only the vertical pipes are kept on the outside of the outside wall, which may be accommodated in a specially designed shaft which can be covered, so that the exposure may lead to ugly look that can be avoided by incorporating this shaft in the vertical stacks in a shaft. So, all the pipes in the sanitary plumbing should be laid straight and you should not use any sharp bend. So, all the junctions should be provided with junction chambers or inspection chambers. In water supply system, we can provide many number of bends, etc. Whereas in the sanitary system, preferably bend should be avoided. So, wherever there is a need to change in direction or two pipes are joining together, it is better to provide inspection chamber or manhole. So, the entire plumbing system should be ventilated, because the wastes are likely to be decomposed and gas to be generated. The pipes are taken above the terrace level and allowed to connected to the atmosphere. So, normally atmospheric air will go into the system and provide the sufficient air. In case of foul gas generation, it will expel the gas through the vent pipe provided at the top of the building. The house sewer shall be connected to the street sewer, keeping the outfall at a higher level and the water level in the public sewer. So, there must be a continuous slope towards the street sewer. So, we have to provide enough number of traps in order to avoid the foul gas entering into the household. The lateral sewers shall be laid with sufficient slopes. So, later we will see the required slope, the grade at which the lateral pipes are to be erected. All the joints are made watertight to avoid the leakage, which may cause nuisance to the households. The layout of the system shall be such that to permit easy cleaning of the pipes in the case of any blockages occurred due to the settlement of the solids. We have to use the high quality sewer pipe in the system, and importantly, we should not allow the rainwater and other yard water to the sanitary plumbing system, because the sanitary sewer already has solids, the different types of solids. We should not allow any rainwater which may carry solids. Ultimately, it will cause problem into the street sewer, where it will cause the settlement leading to blockages and then overflow of the sewage to the through the manhole into the road. All these problems could be avoided only by proper planning of the sanitary plumbing system. So, the sanitary plumbing systems can be designed of the following types. So, it can be two pipe system, one pipe system, single stack system, a partially ventilated single stack system. So, in the two pipe system, so there are two pipes. So, one pipe exclusively for collecting the waste from the water closet. So, this pipe collects the waste from the water closet. Sorry, this is called a soil pipe, because it collects the night soil, also called excreta. So, another pipe which collects the water from the bath, wash basin, kitchen, and this pipe is called waste pipe. For each pipe, a vent is provided. So this is the vent provided to the soil pipe and taken to the top of the terrace. Similarly, another vent is provided to the waste pipe. This also taken to the top. In the two pipe system, there are two pipes. So one pipe is called the soil pipe and another pipe is called the waste pipe. For each pipe, there is a vent arrangement. So totally there are four vertical pipes. 1, 2, 3, 4 vertical pipes are provided. The detail arrangements we can see here. So the vent pipes are shown in the blue color and these waste pipes are shown as red color. Okay. So the two pipe system is the best and efficient system, but very expensive. So you have to provide four stacks, two sets of pipes, and totally there are four vertical pipe. Therefore, the cost will be more. Here you can see the two pipe system. You have the soil pipe connected to the water closet, soil pipe, and each soil pipe is have a vent arrangement. Similarly, the waste from wash basin, the bathroom, kitchen sink, all connected to the waste pipe, for which also you have provided the vent. So totally there are four vertical pipes. All are connected to the common drain pipe, finally to the street sewer. The one pipe system saves the cost. In this system, only one vertical pipe which will collect both excreta and sludge. So both soil and waste are collected in a single pipe, so for which a vent is provided. So this is the arrangement of one pipe system, where you have a single pipe to which the excreta from the water closet and also the wastewater from wash basin, the bathroom, the water bathtub, the kitchen waste, all are connected with the provision for traps. Each and every fixture is provided with a trap and connected to a common pipe which collects both waste and soil. So vent is necessary. Of course, vent is necessary. Totally two pipes are provided, but the system is called one pipe system because one pipe is used for collecting the soil and waste. So this is the one pipe system where it is fully ventilated. Here is a one pipe system. So all the system, all the fixtures are provided with traps and also vent pipe connected to the common pipe, which collects both waste and the soil. So another system is known as the single stack system. Here the single stack is acting as the soil pipe, waste pipe and vent pipe. There is no separate vent pipe. It shall have only one pipe to receive all types of waste, and the same pipe shall be extended above the terrace for about 2 meters above roof level, provided with the cowl arrangement in order to avoid the nesting by birds, to eliminate any gas generated in the system. So this is the single stack system, where you can see the connection to various fixtures. The wash basin is connected to the same pipe. The water closet is also connected to the same pipe. No separate vent pipe is provided. So above the top floor, the pipe is extended above the terrace for about 2 meters. At the top, a cowl is provided. So cowl is a net made of GA or plastic in order to prevent the nesting by birds. Otherwise, bird will build a nest that will prevent the free flow of air. So this is a single stack system, which is a most economical system. The trap water seals must be at least 75 mm. The slope of the branch pipes must be at least 18 to 19 millimeter per meter length. The basins 20 to 120 millimeter per meter length. The water closet 18 millimeter to meter. The vertical sack may be a minimum of 200 mm below the center of the water closet branch. So it is provided, at the center with a sufficient distance. So this is a pictorial arrangement of a single stack system provided to a building, a single stack receiving waste from the different fixtures. So another improvement to a single stack system, because in the single stack system no vent is provided, the same pipe is acting as a vent which is not sufficient to expel the foul gases, therefore it is a partially ventilated. So that is, wherever it is connected to the water closet, the vent is provided. The vent is provided only for the water closet. All other fixtures are connected without vent. So this is called a partially ventilated single stack system. A single stack which collects both soil and waste. In addition, a vent pipe is provided to provide vent to the water closet only. So ventilation of the sanitary plumbing system is very important. So because it is providing a fresh air inlet connected to the lowermost inspection chamber for pushing the foul gas to go out through the top of the vent. So in the ventilated system, there will be a provision for entry of the air at the bottom and outlet at the top. So the normally it goes out, is a vent pipe. So it's wrongly marked. So this is the waste pipe and this is the vent pipe. So in multi-story building there is a common problem. So when all the fixtures are connected to a common stack, when the upper floor is using and the lower floor is not using, and the wastewater is flowing downward, it automatically sucks the water seal in the fixtures in the lower floors. So that may cause the vacuum. So when the wastewater flowing down, it sucks the water seal and causes a vacuum. Because of that, the seal will be broken. So once the seal broken, then the foul gas will enter into the building. So we have to provide some arrangement to avoid the breaking of the water seal. So this the figure shows an arrangement where the water closet is connected to the common pipe. So when the wastewater from the upper floor is flowing down, the water seal from the lower floor may be sucked, therefore it will be broken and the entire wall water will be sucked out, therefore the water seal will be broken. So in order to avoid this breaking of water seal, vent pipe is provided with a connection to trap. So this connection is called the anti-siphonage arrangement. So this will prevent, so whenever the vacuum is created, the air will come through the vent pipe and occupy this length of the pipe and prevents the breaking of water seal. So therefore in the multi-story building where common single stack is provided, then the anti-siphonage arrangement is necessary in order to prevent the breaking of water seal and the entry of the foul gas into the system. So the small pipe connected is known as the anti-siphon pipe that will supply air to the trap of the lower fixture at the time of suction of air. So otherwise it shall act as a vent pipe of the lower fixture. Next, the building sewerage. The building sewerage is the sewer system or pipe system to collect the wastewater from the different fixtures and finally connecting to the municipal sewer or main sewer. The wastewater from different fixtures are collected and discharged into the building sewer. This building sewer should be a minimum of 100 mm size. The sewers, the minimum self-cleansing velocity of 75 centimeters per second should be maintained at least once in a day, because the flow will not be uniform all the 24 hours. During peak hour there will be flow, during the non-peak hour, during the night and other time, there will not be flow in the pipeline. Therefore, at that time there is a likelihood of lesser velocity and settlement of solids. So during the peak time, the morning hours, when all the fixtures are under use, the flow should be sufficient to generate a self-cleansing velocity of 75 centimeter per second. That will flush away the solid settled during the non-peak hours. So we have to maintain this self-cleansing velocity of 75 centimeter per second at least once in a day. In such a way, we have to design the sewer by providing at a proper slope. The sewer should be laid at the specified slope in order to generate the self-cleansing velocity. If it is a 100 mm diameter sewer, it should be laid 1 in 57, so 1 centimeter in 57 centimeter, a grade of 57 centimeter for 1 centimeter fall for every 57 centimeter. If you are using 150 mm diameter sewer, then it should be 1 in 100. For every 100 centimeter, 1 centimeter fall should be given. So then only we can ensure the self-cleansing velocity, so that will prevent the settling of solids. So settling of solids is a problem in general in sewerage system, which will accumulate the solids in the pipe that prevent the flow. The flow will be backflowing and then overflowing through the manholes. The manholes and inspection chambers are necessary. So they are provided as an access into the sewer for cleaning purpose and inspection purpose. And the minimum spacing between two manholes should not be greater than 30 meter. That should be the maximum spacing. So minimum internal dimensions of the manholes. The manholes can be of rectangular or circular. When the sewer depth is less than 0.9 meter from the ground, the manhole size should be 900 mm by 800 mm. When the depth is from 0.9 to 2.5 meter, then size of the inspection chamber may be 1200 mm by 900 mm. The circular manhole is easier for construct, and also for deeper sewers, circular manholes are preferred. These manholes for depths of 0.9 to 1.65 meter may be of 900 mm diameter, internal diameter. For depths from 1.65 to 2.3 meter, it will be 1200 mm diameter. So, this is the typical house sewer connection to street sewer. The fixtures from all the units will come through this street drainage. Here it is shown for a single house. The same can be extended to multi-storied building with a number of houses. All the connections, the vertical slabs are connected to the house drainage, and this is called house plumbing or house drainage. And you have the clean out. In case of there is a blockage in the sewer, we can allow water to flush and clean the sewer pipe. Ultimately, it is connected to the street sewer. In the street sewer, generally it will be flowing partially, only half full it will flow, and the top surface, the top space is provided for the movement of gas, foul gas and air movement. So for that purpose only we must provide the intercepting sewer, intercepting trap at this point to avoid the entry of the gas into the system. So, in this connection, that intercepting sewer is not provided. Instead, the clean out is provided. So, for sewerage system to high-rise building, the interceptor trap is to be provided here in order to prevent the entry of foul gas to the system. So, we have seen the sanitary plumbing system for residential building, where the trap is an important feature, which contains the water seal. The water seal prevents the foul gas entry into the system. So, while planning, sufficient trap should be provided to the different fixtures in order to keep the inside of the house free from the foul smelling. So, with this I conclude the sanitary plumbing lecture. Thank you very much.